peace has cost you your strength. Victory has defeated you.
He's undefeated. He's the reigning.
We don't think much about the underlying social issues that superheroes represent. Their exaggerated characteristics often mask such problems. As kids, most of us look up to superheroes as they inspire us to be strong, fight for justice, and do the right thing. Young children are often caught up in the superficial aspects of what it means to be a hero, like Batman's Batmobile, Captain America's shield, and Spider-Man's shooting webs. Kids look up to superheroes in such admiration on the basis of how they battle villains, yet they miss the superficial point of what they represent. At an earlier age, they're not aware of issues regarding to race, color, or social issues. But for marginalized groups, their outlook often differs, as racial disparities among pop culture role models are more obvious. Without strong role models from their same racial background, kids can question their own ability to be a hero. Because comic books have been around for such a long time, historical racial bias is ever present in their characters and plot lines. The idea of white supremacy still floats from the pages of these books, with the most iconic superheroes being white and with villains depicted in dark colors. This institutionalized racism present in the superhero and comic book industries further blocks minorities from discovering their own individual identities. Toni Morrison's The Bluest Eye, as well as Ralph Ellison's Invisible Man, explain how institutionalized racism serves as an obstacle to an individual identity. The internalized ideas of race creates a dysfunctional character through the eyes of Pecola, who struggles to cope with her own identity as a young African-American girl growing up through the Great Depression in Lorain, Ohio. In this novel, Pecola is a young black girl who has been put outside due to familiar issues. She sees the world through her dark brown eyes, but desperately longs for the blonde hair and blue eyes that she believes fulfills the definition of beauty. Pecola feels powerless through being a young black girl in a society that places her at the bottom of the totem pole. Pecola begins to truly think about how society views her when she sees a doll that emulates her idea of beauty. However, some people beg to differ. The young white girl, Claudia, who possesses this doll, questions why anyone would believe it to be beautiful and rips it apart to search for the underlying beauty, but is left with the metal that lies inside this doll. She feels as though she will be treated differently if she was beautiful. As the book progresses, Pecola experiences various microaggressions, which causes a shift in her mood. For instance, the manager of the pawn shop in her town refuses to even make any form of contact with her because, quote, he does not see her because for him there is nothing to see, end quote. And there is a, quote, total absence of human recognition, glazed separateness. In Invisible Man, the protagonist is constantly searching to find his identity among the confusing functionings of society. From getting kicked out of school to searching for a job in New York City, he discovers that he has to remove himself entirely from society to find out who he truly is, rather than what society tells him he is. As a black man living in a racist society, he constantly attempts to define himself through the expectations imposed on him, which change constantly. In this passage, the speaker begins to question these expectations, saying, I had kept unswervingly to the path placed before me, had tried to be exactly what I was expected to be, had done exactly what I was expected to do. Yet, instead of winning the expected reward, here I was stumbling along, holding on desperately to one of my eyes in order to keep from bursting out my brain against some familiar object swerved into my path by my distorted vision. Realizing he can't live under society's values, he finally takes off the cloak of invisibility on his own identity. Critical race theory envelops the struggle to define one's identity in a racial society that is present in real situations today, as well as in the novels mentioned. As a largely invisible collection of patterns and habits, racism often has a subconscious effect on those that it marginalizes. Racism is integrated into our society and our pop culture, even though it is not often realized. According to Psychology Today, Hollywood has essentially refused to make such Afrocentric films on the grounds that they wouldn't attract a sufficient audience. Black Panther has defied the standard placed by Hollywood with their all-black cast of superheroes. While historically diversity has not been present in comic books and superhero movies, we are seeing a shift in the positive direction with movies like Black Panther debunking racial bias. While there is still much progress to be made, we have worked to elevate the public discourse with race and inequality in America.
You get to decide what kind of king you are going to be.